Hi, in this video we are going to use Arduino as input device. We can use Arduino in two ways for inputs. We can use digital pins for input and we can use analog pins for input. The digital pins can be configured as input or outputs. The analog pins, however, we cannot configure them for outputs, we can configure them only for inputs. If we do want analog output, we may use the digital pins that support pulse width modulation to emulate analog output. There are some Arduino boards which have a built-in digital to analog converter. But the basic one or the common one don't. It does have analog to digital converter for inputs. So to use the digital pins for input, we use digital read. The argument or the syntax is the pin number specified, the pin number that we want to use is put inside the bracket as input argument, and the digital read will take the value of that pin either as high or low. The analog read pin are specified analog pins. We see the Arduino, for example, I have this Arduino setup. So on the side of the source, okay, the pins labeled A0, A1, A2, and A3 are A4. They are analog pins. Okay, they take analog inputs. So in Arduino board, there's a multi-channel, obviously, a 10-bit analog to digital converter. It means that we have a resolution of about 1024, okay, from starting from 0 up to 1023. So we can map our analog voltage, which is either 5 volts or 3.3 volts, into integer values between 0 up to 1023. Okay. For example, on Uno, Arduino Uno, this yields a resolution between for every unit, it will be about 4.9 millivolts, okay, or 0.0049 volts. So let's try an example. I got this example from Arduino website, arduino.cc. It's a basic example, and what it does is that with a press of a button, the light at some pin turns on or off. A push button is connected to pin number 7. And an LED is connected to pin number 13. We have this built-in LED at pin 13, but I put just one outside, an extra, the red one. And I connected in parallel with the push button, the green LED. So when I push the button, I would know that the high is there, high is there at pin number 7. What I'm going to do is I will make a small program, a simple program that will take, that will sense the input, sense the high or low at pin 7, and it will write that on pin 13. I have my Arduino ready, I have my configuration ready as shown and I have this push button. When I press it, the green light will turn on. Sorry about this loose wire. So when I press the button, the green light turns on, which means high is sensed with the green light, and the same goes to pin number 7 through the green wire. And so when I press the button, high is feed or fed to pin number 7. Okay, let's write a program for this. Okay, so open Arduino. So I have Arduino ready, and I'll write a code. First of all, I need an integer or a variable. Okay, let's say integer x. Okay, let's give it a starting value of 0. Okay, my setup would be I'm going to use 2 pins basically. So I'm going to use pin number 13 as output, and I'm going to use pin number 7 as input. Okay, so this is my setup. This part of the program will run only one time. Okay, the loop, main function. So the integer I defined x, I want x to take the value from pin number 7. So x would be our digital read 7. And I will write this on pin 13. Digital write 13x. So that's it. That's pretty straightforward. Okay, let's see how it works. Save this code. Save it as something. Okay, let's upload it. For uploading, see what this is. Okay, connection is fine. Upload. Oh, okay, pin mode, ping, not ping. Pin. Pin mode. P-I-N. Okay, the code is uploaded there. So now as soon as I press the push button, the light at pin 13 should light up. Let's see. Okay, so it's working fine. Let's put some delay. Okay, as it was put a delay. Okay, let's put some delay of 1 second after reading data. Delay 1000 millisecond. So now after I press the push button, the red light at pin 13 should turn on after 1 second, and similarly for turning off. Upload this. Okay, so upload it. Let's see, so I turn this on, and after 1 second the light at 13 turns off. And I leave it, after 1 second the light at 13 will be off. So this is an example of digital input for Arduino. So what the flowchart is should be easy. The code I've just pasted it here. And okay, let's move on to the next part, which is analog input. And we're going to do an example for analog input. What I'm going to do is I'll connect a photoresistor, an LDR, and the LDR I'm going to connect with in a voltage divider configuration, and that the output will be fed to pin number A3. So I will see the value at different light intensities. I will see the value of light in my serial monitor, and then I can modify my code to turn on light when it's dark. So turn on a light, and I can modify it more to turn on two lights at different intensities of light or at different levels of darkness. The configuration I'm going to try is something like this. Okay, I have the resistor and a photoresistor connected in series between 5 and 0 volts, so it acts like a voltage divider. A photoresistor is it's a resistor like any variable resistor, and the resistance depends on the intensity of light. Yeah, so more light would mean less resistance. So let's try this configuration and write a code for it. So let me modify my circuit. Okay, so I have my circuit ready. I put between 5 volts and ground I put a photoresistor in series with a resistor, and then across photoresistor I'm taking the voltage and feeding to pin number A3. So let's write a code for this. Okay, so I'll just modify this one. First of all, I need say int analog pin, or no, put that pin mode wait I need to store this value somewhere. And analog pin A3, so that will be analog pin is our analog pin, and value is 0. Okay, so I'm starting an integer value from 0. Void . So what I need here is I need pin number 13 as output, and I want to see this data on serial monitor. Yeah, so serial begin, like Batman begin. Okay, so still begin, and no, that should be it. Okay, loop function. So the value which I initiated with 0, that will actually be my analog read pin. So I want serial.print. I want print the intensity of light. On my serial monitor. Let's see what are the light intensities that we are getting. Okay, so let's upload this one. Done uploading and check the serial monitor. Okay, so the current light status, that is, I'm getting around 150. Just around 150. Let's put a torch on it. I'll put some light. Get some light. So that goes up to 900. Well, over 900. Okay, with a bright light, it goes up to 900. And 150. If I cover it, my hand comes to between 100, well, less than 100. And if I cover it all together, it comes less than 50. All right. So. Say light turn on let's say 100. Okay, less than 100 should turn the light on, should be enough. Okay, so let's modify this program. If value is less than 100, digital write pin 13, which is the LED high, else digital write pin number 13 low. Easy peasy, very simple. Let's upload this code. See what happens. Okay, so right now the density is high, it's more than 100, so the light at pin 13 is off. Let's cover it and see if we can make it less than 100. There. So as soon as there's my shadow on the sensor, the intensity is coming nearly 100. Let's cover it up more. So it's in the 90s and the light is on. Okay. It will highlight itself when the light is. Yeah. Now maybe I can turn the light off for the room. Let's see what happens. Yeah, okay, if the lights. But there's light only from my monitor. But the light off is nearly 50. Okay, let's turn it on. Okay. So, yeah, this is analog values. I mean, one unit is nearly 50 millivolts. So 150 would be 150 times 50 millivolts. And that's what, that's the voltage I'm getting from this pin. Okay, let's modify it, the circuit, so pin 13 lights up when it's dark. Modify it to turn two LEDs. Let's put on another LED. Okay, let me put it on. Okay, so what I did here, I put an LED at pin number 8, and I'll modify my program. Okay, so I have now another pin in mode 8 and output. So now I want two pins. Two LEDs. I have the red and the green. So I want to, let's say, in certain intensity of light or at certain level of darkness, I want one of them to turn on, and at certain at more darkness, well, the darkness increases, I want to turn on two lights. So okay, let's say, let's come to this. So when it was less than 100, I turned the first one on. Let's make it what is the normal currently, is 100, nearly 140. Okay, let's put a range. Okay, if my value is less than 100, or make it less than 120. If the value is less than 120 and is greater than, say, 80, so I would want pin number 13 to be high. And if value is even less than 80, then what I want is 13 to be high, and also pin number 7 to be high. So now I have two lights for this condition. Yeah, also the LED is more dark. Yeah, okay, it is good enough. So, or you know what, let's make it 50. 50 here and 50 here. Okay, so at this level I'll get two LEDs high. And else, I want everything to be off. Yeah, too lazy to type. Low. Oh, this should work, I hope. Okay, let's upload the code. Hopefully no errors. Yeah, there is error. Semicolon. Very common with programmers. Now what else? This one. Another one, yes. Okay, my code is being uploaded. Nice. Serial monitor. Okay, so according to my code, I should turn the first light on at the value of less than 120 but more than 50. So if I put shadow here on the sensor, there. Yeah, so this is 100, nearly 120 just with my shadow. And it's turning one light on. Let's. So when I cover the sensor, it's coming less than 50, but it's still one light. So, okay, so it's either the connection or, aha, okay, the code. Oh, where did I connect it? I connected to pin number 8. Okay, I connected to pin number 8. It should be pin number 8. Okay, let's re-upload. And let's see. So, once again, when I put the shadow, the red light turns on. Okay, let's cover the sensor and see what happens. There. So, when I cover the sensor, the intensity is very low, it's too dark, so two lights turn on. Okay, when I... Okay, so that's good, it's working. Okay, so this is just a basic introduction on how to use Arduino pins as inputs for analog and digital pins. Okay, flowchart, and here's the code I just shared. It's a slightly different one I tried earlier. And do more, I mean try to make it interesting. If you don't have an LDR, you may use a potentiometer here instead of LDR, because eventually LDR is just a variable resistor. Okay, it can be a potentiometer, or you can just, if you have different value resistors, you just plug different value resistors and see and observe. Let's see what happens if I turn the lights off. Oh, okay, so that will do. So I hope this video was informative. I hope you have learned this, and if you have your Arduino and some LEDs, some variable resistors, it would be a good idea to try some of these. So thank you very much. Thank you for watching.